Hi, I am Shreya and welcome back to Echoes from the Quiet Corner. What if survival of the fittest isn't about strength at all? When Darwin gave us On the Origin of Species, many thought the fittest were the fiercest, those who conquered. But nature, ever patient, whispered otherwise. The fittest are the ones who bend, who listen, who change. And now, as artificial intelligence quietly reshapes our world, a similar truth taps on our shoulder. The ground beneath us is shifting. The question is, will we survive? But maybe we are asking the wrong question. Maybe it's not who wins, but who responds. With grace, with curiosity, with courage. In a world chasing efficiency, we'll discover it's not speed, strength, or smartness that defines survival. It's the art of noticing and the will to evolve, not as machines do, but as humans must. This is not an alarm, it's a mirror, and in its reflection, we may just glimpse the future we still have time to shape. So what Darwin really meant? Let's step back to the mid-19th century, when the natural world still held secrets too sacred to touch. In 1859, Charles Darwin released On the Origin of Species, a book that would reshape how we see life itself. Not with thunder or rebellion, but with quiet, deliberate observation. Contrary to how it's often quoted today, Darwin never said survival of the fittest. That phrase came later from the philosopher Herbert Spencer. And even when Darwin adopted it in later editions, he used it with caution, pairing it with natural selection to clarify, not to crown the strong, but to highlight the responsive. It may metaphorically be said that natural selection is daily and hourly scrutinizing, silently and insensibly working at the improvement of each organic being. Darwin saw nature not as a battlefield but a patient artist, a sculptor of adaptation. It's not the lion that roars the loudest, nor the tallest tree in the forest that guarantees survival. It's the creature that notices subtly, quietly when the light shifts, the one that leans ever so slightly toward the sun, the one that changes not to conquer but to continue. In The Origin of Species, Darwin marveled at the endless forms most beautiful, each shaped not by brute force but by countless generations of small responses to change, variations, mutations, selection, a slow choreography of survival. It's not the strongest or most intelligent who will survive, as the modern paraphrase goes, but those most responsive to change. Today, we live in a world moving faster than natural selection ever did. AI doesn't wait for generations, it updates in seconds. And still, Darwin's whisper travels through time. Adaptation is not surrender, it's resilience in motion. So when AI writes a better headline or solves a math problem in milliseconds, we are not called to compete with its speed, but to understand what makes us different. Our strength lies not in doing what machines do, but in seeing what they can't. In noticing, feeling, reimagining, and shifting gently with the wind without losing the root of who we are. Survival is not brute force, it's fluidity. It's sensing the wind change and adjusting your sails. With machines that write, speak, and diagnose faster, cheaper, tireless, this lesson echoes louder than ever. Let's step back further to the early 1800s. The Luddites smashed machines, yes. But not because they hated progress, they loved dignity. They fought, not against innovation, but against exploitation. Their battle wasn't with technology, but with what that technology displaced. Jobs, community, security. And now as ChatGPT writes, Midjourney paints and AI quietly humps behind countless screens, we hear echoes of that fear again. What if I'm next? What if the world moves on without me? This is not like before. AI is not the printing press, not the steam engine. AI is not the ATM. It's something more elusive. A shapeshifter, 1,000 invisible hands doing 1,000 different tasks, writing poems, grading papers, filing taxes, composing music, analyzing lungs, it doesn't replace a job, it seeps into all jobs. And worse, it learns not by design, but by data. By watching us, our clicks, our speech, our habits, it mimics the very fabric of our daily lives. What happens when the machine doesn't take your job but becomes a version of you? To lose a job is to lose a rhythm, a name, a shape. We say, I am a teacher, I am a writer, or maybe I am a designer, not I do teaching or I do writing. So when AI creeps in with mimicry, we feel it in the soul, not just the paycheck. We don't just fear being replaced, we fear becoming irrelevant, invisible, forgotten. And what if adaptation doesn't mean erasure, but refinement? Let's look not at loss, but at transformation. In healthcare, radiologists use AI not as competition, but as a second set of eyes, spotting patterns a human eye may miss. The result? More time for empathy, for presence, for being human. In classrooms, AI tutors adapt lessons to each child. But the warmth, the guidance, the spark of confidence, that's still the teacher's gift, not something AI can give. In law, AI drafts contracts, sorts files, reads judgments, but strategy, argument, knowing when to pause, when to push, that remains human. In all these spaces, the machine hums quietly. The person guides, the environment changed, and so the organism evolved. So how do we move forward? Here is how we begin. Name the fear, not to dismiss it, but to understand it. Fear is data. Let it speak. Keep learning. Not just tech skills, but creative thinking, collaboration, ethics, curiosity. Redefine worth. If a task is automatable, look for the non-automatable within it. Emotion, context, nuance, joy, build together. The future isn't made by tech alone. It's shaped by policy, by people, by shared values. If the last revolutions left some behind, let this one carry us forward, all of us. So what is fitness now? It's not muscle. It's not mastery of code. It's not becoming machine-like to survive. It is the ability to ask better questions. It is the ability to hold contradictions, to stay soft in a world racing to harden, to unlearn, to realign, to carry wonder in one hand and wisdom in the other. AI may rewrite the world, but it cannot write us. Not our dreams, not our grief, not our soul. We are still the storytellers. Let's choose the ending well. You have been listening to Echoes from the Quiet Corner. If the ground feels like it's moving, take heart. The wind that bends the tree is the same wind that spreads its seeds. Adapt, align, and let your next version bloom. Let this not be an age of anxiety, but an age of exquisite responsiveness. Let this be our echo of Darwin. Thank you for listening. Until next time, stay curious and may your quiet corners be rich with echoes that know how to listen as always. Bye.